I once again, so I decided to make another technical analysis video, and basically because there's no tourism, there's no events, there's no DJing, so I'm doing another video for investment and trading. Okay, so the previous video we were on the top, as I said, I warned everyone that if everyone is wants to buy Bitcoin and their families ever, and you see all the euphoria on the news, that's the time to sell. And in terms of technical analysis, everything was pointing down, all the indicators were pointing down, but you see all the friends and media, that was a sell signal. Then we got the flush, we got a continuation of the flush down, and now we are trying to find support on the monthly to try to see if we manage to push higher or up. Once again, we don't know until when, until where, but now we will have the monthly close to decide if this is the higher low on the monthly, or if we keep on doing lower lows and we just push a little bit up and we keep on red until we reach these supports, which are stronger, especially this one on lower targets. But until there, if we hold this area, which is this monthly, this candle here, this close here, this is where we are trying to hold until the end of the month. We need to close above this yellow line, which I draw for this area. When we came down, we came to test mathematically this area here, this candle close on the monthly, which was a support. And we bounce from there, and now we are trying to see if we manage to hold. But remember, after all this flush, indicators are still pointing down. Something like this can happen, or something like this can happen. We come down, we go up, we don't do a higher high, and then we keep on coming down until we got the flush. And let's see the support, or we come down like this until we reach the 20 and the 21, these lines here. Plus the Fibonacci areas and try to see if we have enough strength to go to all-time highs or to do another lower high on this resistance here. So, but everything is possible, you just need to manage your risk. Once again, I'm giving private classes via Zoom to a few Portuguese friends, and they are learning how to play this game. Because it's all about risk management and not lose money. And read the charts and what the price is telling you, because the price is telling you a story on every close, on the monthly, the weekly, the hourly, and the supports and resistance. The indicators will help, the volume will help, and the market sentiment will help a lot too. Euphoria is to sell or take profits. And fear and uncertainty is to start buying, but with risk management, because you need to buy on support. And otherwise, this is just a gamble, and the gamblers normally lose, and the house normally wins. Okay, so we are trying to hold the support now. This is the 12 exponential, so we need to close the month above, still 1 week to go. And we have the weekend ahead. The weekend we need to go for the weekend for the weekly candles. But for now, everyone that managed to buy this dip, you can use the stop loss below. And then if we come down, you can take profits on the way up now. If we come down, you can be like with a profitable trade or not lose any money. And okay, so if we start flushing down, we have this support on the moving average plus all this. This is the area that we went up that I explained on the previous video that we went up without coming down, without testing it as support. But we can have bounces here, we can have bounces here. This is a long process that can take a few time, nobody knows. It can be very fast, but it can also take months. We got this support, we go higher, we don't know until where. When we come down, we can come down to these areas and just stay a few months here, suddenly push a little bit higher, suddenly we can have a crash, and then maybe a big buyback again from the lower area, and then suddenly back down, consolidate and start to try to push higher to the bigger targets of $100,000 and up. Let's see if it's still during this year. Otherwise, maybe in 2 years, 3 years. And I think we will go there. I'm a bull in crypto. That's why I've been here since 2017. But I know that there is volatility and the big players want to make money. They will like to buy low, sell high. When there's no more liquidity here, they will sell so they can buy lower. And they have to create hype and put people, new people on the market to buy so they can sell. And then they will buy lower again. When the newbies don't start selling, they will buy back and then the price goes up. So you need to learn how to play this game. And all these chart analysis, technical analysis will help you because everything is very precise. And it's all about risk management and know and be patient. And because for a market crash, you can wait 2 years, 3 years, 1 year, 5 years, 6 years. But when it happens, you need to be prepared and act. Okay, so this is the monthly, as I explained, the monthly closes are very important and the supports and resistance. Okay, so now going for the weekly, see we are in this range, the white lines that always hold the price down. When we are below, this is the bear market starting. The bull market will only resume when we start having weekly closes above the white line and also this 20. These ones now are acting as resistance and we can go up, but then we should come down. Nobody knows, but that's what the market is telling. Indicators on the weekly, as you see, all the crashes, all these areas, we have to, all the investors have to buy when the prices reaches the RSI here on the 30 or below. As I explained before, it's a matter of being patient. And if you're just, if you want to make some money in between, you can do swing trades from one area to the area, like from here to here or to here or to here, take profits and then out and you put your stop loss below one of these weeks. And if the price goes higher, try to put the stop losses, go do some trailing stop losses, like when you start to go for the daily. We have this hammer here and price is now trying to go for the 12, 21, this will act as resistance. Let's see if the bulls push the price higher. We were on oversold since here. We got the flush down. Now we are trying to push higher, but we are still below resistance, which will be here, will be here. And the market will only start resuming more positive. We start closing above 43, above the 200 exponential here, and the 200 simple, and then just start to do higher, push higher, then come down, make a higher low, and then try to push higher with higher lows. For now, we did a lower low from this low and a lower low, so we are trying to push higher, but this can be a bear flag to push down. So how to read this area? We were like in this range for weeks, and then suddenly we have this confirmation when we got this candle here closing below that one. We closed below support and we got the flush down. But the chart was already telling you, because we were below the 21, the moving average here on the daily, and the price just pushing down, and this will act as a resistance low. Only if the bulls start to push, have enough strength to push above here, it's still possible. So, but when we were coming down, we never know how this candle, this could have been red and keep on coming down. You could just wait until on the daily until this happens, and then you got this retest here from the support with a higher low, and you could have bought here and put a stop loss here. So you could have done this, or when we were coming down, you start to go to the low time frames, we were flushing down here. Remember, indicators on the RSI were already crushed here. Suddenly we get this hammer. This is a reversal candle, as you see, pushing the price. And suddenly we went up, come down, did a higher low. We test this support, push higher above. We came down one more time, test this support here on these candles, another higher low. And now we are coming to test another support, trying to to another higher low to try to push higher to this range here, and then keep on doing higher lows to see if the price acts. If not, on the daily, we might just come here and then flush down. So we got also these big green candles saying that the buyers are stepping in, and now we are just ranging but trying to push higher. But remember, big resistance from here. The support is here, as we see. This is the support, and now we are here, and we need to start closing above this area, and let's see if the bulls have enough strength. How to get this? You could have waited, and then you don't try to get this area, because this could get coming down. As soon as you have this candle here, it's showing that the bulls are coming, and then you try to get, you have the risk managed with a stop loss maybe here. You can have bids on the way down with a stop loss here, and suddenly this one came to test basically this area here, the support, and suddenly wicked up. So you could have bids and then would make the stop loss here and make bids on the way up, and now you can mark more bids and the stop loss will be here or here or here, and you can just add to your position. So, but we were crushed, and if we put the 15 minutes when we went down, this is how you trade. But remember, this is not investment, this is just for trading. But as you see, so you understand how technical analysis works on these big flushes, you can put also the 5 minutes, but even the 15 minutes was already fine, because when you have all the technicals with these lines that you draw, you learn how to draw the monthly. This was the monthly support that I had drawn, and suddenly we got a buying candle. Everything was red here on the, as we see here on the volume, all red, sell. Suddenly we got this wick, came down once again, closed above the monthly support, and we did the low, higher low, and then after another 15 minutes, you get the green candle, confirming the support with another higher low. So you could have bought only here, then you put the stop loss below here, this area, or here, or have a few more buys here and the stop loss below here. You will have a few bids here, and suddenly the price went up. And then we confirmed the 50 on the weekly, 50 simple moving average with this candle, and then we got the technicals all working. As we can see, remember, when we were here, we were not below oversold. Here was really extreme oversold, below the 30s, lower 20s. On the RSI, that's when we got the big bounce. So all the technicals are on, and you will learn with practice how to play this game. Remember, we got the push up, and then we got the bull flag. We got this confirmation line up, and then we are going up on the moving averages, and then today we still hold the moving average. We got the confirmation here on the 12 exponential on the monthly, which I have drawn, confirmation here, push up, confirmation on the monthly support. We did another bull flag, confirmation here, and the price is pushing higher. So all the technicals for risk management are working, and you can make money. Like for today, you could have already made, for instance, today, if we bought here or even here, from here, imagine you bought on the moving average and on the monthly supports. Until now, you already made 4%, more than you make in 4 years in a bank or 10 years. So only today. So. And then you could already sell everything now, got out. You see the bull mark, the bull volume coming. So the bulls are taking controls, at least until we reach the liquidity pool on the higher areas, which will be, as I explained, the daily, and it will be these moving averages. You could take profits around here and here, and then put your stop loss maybe below here or here, and control your risk, because this can be just a bear flag, but you can make money until here. Okay, so this is how you play the game. You just need to be patient and understand to buy support, sell resistance, and take profits. Let's see if the monthly holds. try to push higher. If we hold, next target will be this candle close here, plus that week and this week, especially this candle close here, and then we will decide if we have another push higher. If have many people try to short, maybe we have another push higher. But remember, with these lines, I'm seeing this trend line here. I can also draw one from this week with that week and give an area around here. And we can even come here. And then when everyone is bullish again, thinking that we go to the 100, we can have a big flush down. So everything is possible, or we don't pass this area here, or we don't pass here. Let's see how we close the month and week. And with the monthly and the weekly close, you will have clues to see where the price is heading. But remember, today we were already doing 4% and trying to push higher, but we still have 1 week to go. Remember, we have all these trend lines that they work quite well. It's a matter of patience for the price to come to test the lower areas. Can take months, weeks, years, but you need to be prepared when it happens. You need to be there and prepared to buy and make money and use your risk manage for investment. And for now, just swing trades and trades. You can make good money if you know about technical analysis. And yeah, that's it. I'm speaking about Bitcoin, but if we put S&P 500, Nasdaq, DGI, QQQ, gold, everything is the same. Look at S&P 500, all-time high. Because of the Fed printing money, we have all these rising wedge, you have all these patterns that if we break these and all the sectors, all the we break down, we will have a big flush. Remember, this is a big bubble as well. The stock markets, S&P 500, huge bubble. This is the monthly chart. Look at this. The only crash on COVID was this one, which was nothing, was just a small correction. And push higher again, suddenly all-time highs again. This is a huge bubble, something like this. Remember, we can come down like this, push another leg up, and suddenly a big flush down. This will happen sooner or later. It's a matter of patience. Remember, if you're an investor on the stock market, you have to buy on these levels. You can make lots of money by swing trading the supports with risk management. But if you're an investor for the long term, you have to buy the dips. You could have bought a little bit here. If we come down, you buy a bit more here. If you come down, you can buy more on the way down. But indicators, remember, on the COVID, we came here. We need to come down at least way down below. So we are in a big bubble, Nasdaq. So it's a matter of patience. Look at this, that we will crash. And when we crash, we will come to the big flush down. Remember, something like this is can happen, and suddenly we have a big move down, which the 200s are here on the monthly, and this is an area that is possible, but it's a matter of seeing where the price comes and be prepared to buy any of these moving average support, and yeah, so that's it. Indicators still pointing up. Look at the RSI. The maximum we came to top out was here. We can still go higher. Pushing, but when we come, that will be dramatic and the bubble will pop. So you need to be check what everything is doing, and the dollar as well. Gold now is correcting again, coming to test the support. We push up, suddenly push down. Everyone was very bullish, but we need to see if we hold here to try to push higher. Bitcoin can do something like this as well. So holding the 21, pushing higher, but suddenly doesn't pass the whole time high. And this is what's happening with Bitcoin. We will actually, gold is doing kind of the same. Look, the 12, suddenly we might hold these months and we push higher, but suddenly we don't pass the whole time high. And then we back then, and then we come down to the 20 or the 21, try to push higher, but suddenly another rejection. So there's a big area here that the price is not passing, so we need to come down to test where the buyers will step in. If the buyers don't step in this area, I'm seeing lower areas and maybe around this area here or here or here. Nobody knows. Just be prepared see what the price is telling you a story. Look at what happened here, all-time high, trying to push higher, all the 12, we didn't pass, 21, push higher, even tried to do a higher low here, put everyone bullish, and suddenly we didn't go to all-time high and big crash. This is something that can happen with Bitcoin. It's happening again here on the tops, and the price will have to confirm. If we hold this, we can still push higher, but or something like this can happen, but seems like, look at indicators, we already reached the peak here on the RSI pointing down. You're an investor where you invest on the low areas. See what the data is telling you. Look, this is where you invest in these areas here below. It can take years weight of weight, but you need to be prepared when it happens. It's when you make money as an investor. It's a patience game, but you can make money in between with swing trades and trades. When the price closes above support, you buy the support, sell the resistance, and make good money in between without having to wait all these years. So technical analysis, market sentiment is very important, but the price action, what the price is telling you on the monthly and the weekly, it's very important and tells you a story. Okay? Hope this helped. Bitcoin trying to push higher now, but still, as I explained, what's happening here, just check the chart of gold. We can do something like that, but good money can be still made. So if we hold here, we can push higher here. If we don't pass here, we come down. All the support on this area, I don't know which one, maybe touch this one and close above the other on the monthly. So it will hold maybe this support here. And then let's see if we have enough strength, if we do a whole time high, or if we do something like gold, and then we will come to the lower areas. And yeah, so remember, indicators will tell you a story. Price action especially is telling you a story. 30 minutes. So here we go. Very simple. Look, low, higher low, higher low. Go up, maybe we come here, come down, do a higher lower on this area and keep on pushing higher. And all the technicals, everything worked. Support, resistance, monthly support here, trying to push higher. Fibonacci has resistance. Trend line has resistance. Any closes above here, we will push to the monthly close. This is the previous monthly close. This area, we went down. And these candles, we didn't go here to test as resistance. So this is the area, a liquidity area I'm seeing. If we manage to close above here, I'm seeing this area and here. If we close above, I'm seeing the 43. If we don't close above here or we reject from here, we can come just to here and then back down here and then come to test the lower levels. We are in this range now and this one. So everything is very technical, and if you learn how to do this, you can be a profitable and consistent trader or investor without losing money, or at least what you lose, it will be very low if you learn how to play this game. So here we are pushing to this area, and if we do this today, imagine if you have made this trade today from this trend line, or even just from here. From here to here, it's already 4%. If we come here, it's 6%, and you can do 6% in one day. That is something that you can take 6 years or 10 years in a bank to do. So understand that this is risk capital, but if you control your risk, you can make money and make good money. Okay, so if you need any lessons, I can do it by Zoom. Very easy. I can do 2 hours lessons explaining how all this works. I don't think with 2 hours we learn something that for me took like 4 years to learn. But if you do like a few more classes and I explain you everything, all the indicators, all these indicators, how they work. For instance, even without this, you can make, imagine, you put super trend and it will give you buy and sells. Look, only with this, look, indicators gave you the buy here, sell there, buy here, you already made all this profit. Imagine if you got indicator here and you bought here and you sold where it told you was here, you made 15% in the last 2 days or 3 days. So only with indicators. And if you look at it on the daily, gave you the sell from the top, sell, 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 sell. So don't care about the news, the indicators were already giving you the sell. And now they didn't give you the buy, only when we start closing above this area, they will start giving you buys. For now, not yet, because it's still a sell area, resistance will be here. So we are trying, Bitcoin is trying, indicators are still trying to push higher. Let's see if we manage to pass this area from here to here, one candle at a time, and then it's giving you a story. But even from here to here, you make money if you sell here as a trader. So indicators help you a lot as well. Moving average, supports, resistances. For instance, the top of Bitcoin, we can put this. If you look, also what was giving you the top of Bitcoin, price cycle top daily, look at the weekly, top. Although this indicator was created around this area, so gave you the tops with the previous data and gave you this top, which got the data from previous cycles. So all cycles are, I think this cycle is different than the others, will we have more extremes, but gave you the top. So many people were buying here, but if you use technical analysis, you were selling basically, and now you are just be patient, waiting for an investment. Okay? I think this will help you. And this is a formation, this is a head and shoulders. Head and shoulders is a bearish formation. So, and if we go from here, if you measure down, I think we will come to these areas here. It's a matter of patience. So be prepared, buy support, sell resistance, make money, investor, just wait, be patient. Stock market, commodities, anything, everything works on the same way. Coca-Cola. For instance, Coke, you saw the news that Ronaldo took the Coca-Cokes and gave like a create prejudice and a big sell to Coke. But no, it's not Ronaldo. Look at this. If we look at the weekly, this is the resistance, these channels of lines that the price comes from the past. I can even put the monthly. So look at these tops, you make lines with the tops, look, you create these channels, these are perpendicular lines, and basically when Ronaldo did that was exactly on the moment when the price touched the resistance, like here, and we crashed, Coke touched the resistance, and then we put the weekly. See, exactly, this was exactly on the day that Ronaldo move the Cokes, but it wasn't him. Basically, it was the chart where the sellers are selling and taking profits, and now they will buy low on the moving averages here. And this is how you trade. So don't look at the news. The news are not telling you any story. The price action is telling you a story, and the news are a reaction to the price, because they only react after the price is telling you something. So it wasn't Ronaldo. It's not Elon Musk that moves the market, because the charts were already telling you the buys and sells. He's just following the chart with his analysts, technical analysts. So forget all this manipulation. It's not manipulations. It's how the market works. So forget what you see in the news. But the news are good to see the market sentiment. When you see euphoria, it's to sell. When you see fear, it's to buy. And then you use the indicators to give you the entries, and everything reacts, look at this, mathematically, and pushes the price higher. Look at the moving averages pushing the price will come here, will try to push higher again, and we are